A few days ago, Nintendo announced their new Switch model, the Nintendo Switch OLED, which comes with a beautiful new white color, a new 7-inch OLED screen, improved kickstand, and a new dock with a built-in LAN port. And all this is due to be released on the 8th of October. However, a lot of people, myself included, wonder just how much better the new OLED screen will really be. Is it on par with the new OLED screen on the PlayStation Vita? Is it far better? Or is it worse? And a lot of other people have been wondering if they fixed Joy-Con drift for the Switch OLED's Nah, I'm just playing. We all know Nintendo didn't fix that shit. Well, wonder no longer, because I, Seven, have gotten an early hands-on on the new Nintendo Switch OLED. I don't have an early hands-on. But do you know who does? Tom Marks from IGN, Alessandro Filari from GameSpot, and Dieter Bonn from The Verge, that's who. And they were oh so kind to share their genuine thoughts on the new Switch model, so that people may have an idea of what they're getting themselves into before throwing $350 at Nintendo. Keep in mind that there's no actual footage of the OLED model in their hands, so let's just trust them when they say they got their hands on them. Let's start with Tom Hanks from IGN. He says, "The strength of the new display, unsurprisingly, becomes even more obvious when turned on, immediately shining bright and clear from pretty much any viewing angle I tried. Honestly, it's not an exaggeration to liken its vibrance to when the Game Boy Advance SP got an updated model with a far brighter screen, making the original Switch look noticeably dimmer if compared directly. Its colors are richer too, and I'm not kidding when I say Breath of the Wild's grassy fields looked almost cartoonishly green viewed side by side. The next most exciting feature of the OLED model, somewhat surprisingly, is actually its improved kickstand. It's no secret that the base model's offset kickstand is flimsy and unreliable, but I wasn't expecting this version to provide such a resounding response to the issues of its predecessor." Yeah, that's even more ironic. "Not only does it stretch all the way across the back of the Switch, its hinges offer a satisfying amount of resistance so that you can easily lean it at a nearby angle and be confident it will stay that way. It's extremely sturdy, with the same tactile matte finish as the back of the Switch Lite. If it weren't for the charging port still being blocked while standing up, I'd say the need for a third-party stand is now all but dead. And that's honestly pretty reassuring considering the difference between the original Game Boy Advance and the newer Game Boy Advance SP model, also known as the AGS-101 model, is pretty substantial. It sounds like the OLED model doesn't lift the Switch from the table, so you're still gonna have to get like a third-party stand if you want to charge your Switch." Alright, let's move on to Alessandro from GameSpot. He says, "While people who regularly play in docked modes with solid TV sets aren't going to be blown away by the OLED model's visuals, this still makes handheld mode look way better than it ever has before. It honestly made me interested in seeing how many of my other favorite games like Bayonetta 2 and Smash Bros. Ultimate would look on the new display. The key areas in which the Switch OLED sees improvements are focused on the handheld experience. While the handheld mode is convenient, it also offers less than perfect conditions for experiencing certain games compared to playing it docked. While I often prefer to play Switch games in handheld mode, there are times where I do play games in the TV mode, which allows me to get a better sense of the game's visuals and performance. Unfortunately, the significant improvement here being the OLED screen means that the main benefit of the new model will be lost when playing in docked mode. So it's pretty obvious that if you have a fantastic TV and you mainly play in docked mode, that the OLED screen won't suit your fancy." Alessandro also reiterates that the new model is almost exclusively for those that prefer to play or primarily play in portable mode, not for those that play almost exclusively docked. However, I personally feel that the fact that games on portable mode look better than they ever have before will be enough to entice a lot of current Switch owners to purchase the OLED model. Alright, last but not least, Dieter from The Verge. He says, "So the Nintendo Switch OLED model justifies its existence, but does it justify an upgrade? For most people, the responsible answer is no. The improvements here are not going to unlock any new game experiences or capabilities, they just make the current experiences a little nicer. I don't think I'm going to be responsible though. I knew that going in that it was just a Switch with a bigger and brighter screen. I know after playing it in handheld mode feels like much less of a compromise than it does today." Yeah, yeah, pretty much. I feel like Dieter's impression is the most straightforward. It's literally just a new Switch with quality of life changes. No new capabilities, no new game experiences, just a nicer screen with a new kickstand. And a built-in LAN port at the back of the dock. But let's pretend that you can't get a LAN adapter on Amazon for $15. Anyway, those are all the impressions we've gotten for the unreleased OLED model so far. I mean, there's not really much to say about it. That's pretty much that. If I end up getting the OLED model for myself, I'll probably make a box opening video and maybe even do like a side-by-side comparison with the Switch I have today. Granted, I haven't sold it at that point. But if y'all want to see the box opening, be sure to smash that like button.
Boy, if you don't get...
And subscribe and all that if you want to support me and the channel. As always, thank you for watching and enjoy the rest of your week.